All right, what's up? It's Shake, and I have with me G Soldier.
What's up with it, G Soldier? Writer, director, performer, hip hop artist, poet. I do it all, you know.
You filmed battles too, correct? So when you were at events in that early era, so to speak, so there was there a lot of people filming battles at the time in the early 2000s, before like 2005, you know, like in the freestyle scene? What do you?
I probably was the only one that I knew at the time. I had the camera with the AMM tapes, you know. So I still got all the old battle. I got some battle tapes from their favorite battlers that nobody has ever seen. So I need to get the mugs transcribed.
Were you a fan of Scribble Jam and kind of like people like Immaculate Thesaurus and that kind of style of battle rapping? And like, how did, because getting into No Coast later, that style kind of meets up a little bit for you. So what do you think about that? Like the different style, like Grind Time versus what you were doing back then?
Yeah, you know, I watch Scribble Jam. Like I said, I've been a fan of. I used to watch the Blaze battles on HBO and all that. But I think it was a great thing, because what I loved about Grind Time and what helped me out is the versatility. You know what I'm saying? See, I love URL, the street stuff, but you battle the same person. You already know what you're going to get. And in Grind Time, I battled Asian people, I battle big people, black people, white people, multi people, you know what I'm saying? People use multi, so it made me able to adapt and write to a different way, and I loved it, you know what I'm saying?
So when did you first hear about No Coast? When did you first hear about all these other battle rap leagues that were popping up? What got you into that?
It was my homie Double Deuce. What you need to come back out, Double.
Yeah, he does. Yeah. Hey, we miss you. Double Deuce, Master Shake on Facebook. I've actually wanted to hit him up, so big ups, Double Deuce. Big ups, Sunny Bamboo, Lush One, everyone from Grind Time, by the way. So, yeah, like you were saying.
But yeah, my boy Double Deuce, he was like, hey, man, it's this new league. He was like, it's close to you, too, like it's in Missouri, you know. And I've been an open-minded person anyway, so it reminded me of Grind Time, because Grind Time always had that family environment, you know, like, once you finish, you go kick it, drink, you talking, you know what I'm saying? Ain't no fighting, no none of that. And that's one thing I respected. I'm like, I like this. You know what I'm saying? This is a cool league.
So. Yeah, so you think it was a different environment a little bit than street status, where there was a lot more kind of like, okay, yeah. Please explain.
Man, it's street status, man. It's fights. And you know, like I said, we was the very first battle, me and Young L, and both our camps had a fight that night. You know what I'm saying? Like, it was that intense, you know what I'm saying? So
tell me about your battle with T-Rex. What do you have to say about your battle with T-Rex, G-Soldier?
Before I say that, let me, like Eminem said, you have to live it to feel it. You didn't, you wouldn't get it or see what the big deal is. You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to live that, to feel that pain and fight. But for Rex, like, one thing I respect about No Coast, you know, they saw me putting in work, and I think Debbie hit me up. He was like, would you want to battle Rex? He was like, we want to. And he's like, what a reward, which is crazy. But let me tell you the story behind it. So I was super excited, right? I think my battle was like 4 or 5 weeks away or whatever. So once I learned that out, I got arrested for some traffic tickets. So I was in jail for 14 days. So I couldn't even write for Rex, you know what I'm saying? So nobody knows this. So I was like, I hate this about it. And I got my biggest battle coming up. So then, yeah, so I could write. So then when I came out, and this is, I'm going to break this down to y'all. Okay, I had 10-minute raps. Then Debbie hit me up. He was like, hey, man, Rex only want to do, I think he said 5 minutes. I was like, okay. Then like 2 or 3 days, he was like, he only gonna do 3 minutes. So all the material I had to cut out, you know, I was like, I was super ready. I was like, man, I had to cut out some great stuff. So, and then one thing I was listening to, which I probably would never do again. I was, people used to be like, hey man, you be too aggressive. Like, you know, so like I would just listen to all these different facets, which I regret. But you know, it was a learning experience. But But when I battled Rex, what I wrote, I was like, I know people look at him as a legend, so I was like, I want to be as disrespectful as I can. So that's why I did the fuck your mama and fuck everybody in your family that, you know, said. I was like, I got to be, like, super disrespectful in Ash. But, so, yeah, I mean, on our trip down there, I was just, you know, like I said, I was super ready. I feel, with the battle, I feel I had better bars, but Rex had great performance. You know what I'm saying? So, I feel, you know, he had a better performance, but I think my bars was better. But I learned a lot from the Rex battle, especially when it was over. I was like, yeah, you know, it was good. And then when I looked at the comments, I was like, oh, my God. And there's people in the comments, they'd be like, G-Soldier ain't got no neck. Or they'd be like, I'm like, what does that have to do with the battle? it was people on there like, hey, man, I just skipped past G-Soldier around. I'm like, what? You know what I'm saying? So, but I had to learn, you know, like, that just taught me, like, that's what anybody, like, Rex is on a higher level, so no matter what, who it would have been, they're going to be like, ah, you know what I'm saying? Absolutely. But
did you tell us, obviously you filmed rap battles and you were a battler yourself, but that kind of led to you doing filmography and getting into that? Just tell us real quick what's going on with that.
Yeah, so I got my bachelor's degree in film production from Webster University, and I wrote and directed a couple of short films. You know, they made it to the International Film Festival. So right now I'm working on a 6-part drama series. It's called The Lou. It's a story about these eight friends, and it takes place after the Darren Wilson verdict. So you get to see how they life, you know, transpires on their journey.
Thank you again for coming out and for helping us do this first stop tournament. Real quick, I'll run down the matchups. Trey G versus Sam I Am. We did that. Artem, his opponent, no showed. We're moving on. He's going to be in the next round. THC versus Orlando Coolridge. And then we have one more battle, J Skills versus Mulatto. And then the first round, they'll advance. So keep tabs on that. No Coast St. Louis. That's what is currently going on in No Coast in the Missouri division. So thank you so much, guys, for checking out this video. Like, subscribe, NoCoastRaps.com. That was a great interview. So yeah.
No problem. Shout out to Shake. Bars.